don't want Oscar award. What we want is, you know, it's a typical Nigerian movie. So that's on the one end.
Omi is throwing a birthday party this year.
I'm thinking Nigerian paradise.
Oh, and you, my beautiful goddess, will be Yemoja, coral everywhere.
I like that.
Your 50th cost $1 million.
Mm-hmm.
That means your 51st will be higher.
Well, naturally.
Flowers from where? The garden in heaven.
You know what you've been up to with money.
Baba.
Do you know these people that you are talking about? These are juggernauts of the East.
Not for this movie.
But this is their kind of a movie, and how powerful we are.
No.
So you and the children planned this in order to twist my arm so that I won't have my 51st birthday. Is that what it is?
You're just plain Brooke. I beg your pardon.
I bought Googie.
Googie?
Yes, I bought Burberry.
Basically, you just did mad shopping.
Did you follow me?
And then welcome to yet another edition with the consultee. If this is your first time seeing me, my name is Chacha Wabara, and what we do here are movie reviews and trailers, as well as everything else in between. If that's what you're looking for, please sit back and enjoy, and don't forget to hit on the subscribe button, turn up your post notifications so that you'll be alerted when a new video comes up. Right, so our returning subscribers and viewers, thank you and welcome once again. We're reviewing the Nigerian movie known as The Blinks of Lagosians, directed by Bolanle Peters, 2019 Nigerian Nollywood movie that features a family, the Holloway family, 1% of 1% of Lagos, right? Those ones who have class, who have the money, who have the connections, who have the power, who have the political strength of Lagos per se. So this movie is centered around a family known as the Holloway family, Akin Holloway, starring Mollalisa Chinda, Ellen Paul, Broshagi, Busola Ayola, Toyin Abraham, Benga, Titiloye, Elvina Ibru, Sharon Onja. Sharon Onja was one of the daughters of Akin Holloway. And then we also have Osas Igodaro, Jimmy Odunkoya, not forgetting Eku Edewo and Alex Ekubo, right? Now, moving forward, this movie, I'm going to break it down a little bit because it has lots of stories in the movie. Now, the Holloway family has to do with this man and his wife and two daughters, especially the man and his wife, Akin Holloway and his wife. They spend money like water. Now get this, as much as they were spending money, you know, they were knee deep in debt. They had bills to pay, they were owing the government, the banks were closing in on them. But Jide Koshoko, who was Baba Eko, although his role was brief, was his Akin Holloway's godfather. So Jide Koshoko kept on, you know, pushing back the banks and even the governor from closing in on Akin Holloway and the loans they kept on collecting so that they can repay it back. That was what Jide Koshoko did for the Holloway family, and Akin Holloway kept, you know, remained loyal to Jide Koshoko till the death of Jide Koshoko by a girl. Yeah. He died on top of a girl. But you know, Akin Holloway's wife, who didn't care about cost, who wanted to show, you know, everyone that they could afford anything that they wanted. They could afford to organize a birthday party for over $1 million, wanted to spend money like water and didn't care about, you know, the loans and the bills piling up. They were so rich, yet they were not even paying their staff, their domestic staff who had been working with them. They kept on saying, oh, no money, you know, we're in debt, they are closing in on us, blah 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 blah. But they were ready to burn all that money on a birthday party, buying Bentley, buying latest Mercedes Benz and all of that. They had two daughters, right? One was married but had she was a relationship expert, but at the beginning of the movie, till even almost the end of the movie, her marriage was not a happy one. Her husband was always avoiding her. Her husband didn't want to have anything to do with her. She was unhappy in her marriage, but would always pretend for the camera and always type, "Yeah, my husband did this, my husband did that." And then on the other hand, Sharon Onder was the other daughter. Her name was Tokunbo. You know, she was a script writer, a movie script writer, who had a run-in with Alex Ekubo, who exhibited everything that, you know, all these Igbo businessmen exhibit. Like, I don't care about the process. All I think about is the money. How much am I going to gain from this movie? If I shoot the movie like this with Osofia and all that, you know, people will buy the movie. Everybody's gonna buy the movie, you know, and we'll make too much money. Meanwhile, Sharon Onder Tokunbo is like about the class and all that. And it's like, in nature, they go, see this one, that one will not bring money, it will only give you Oscar award. We don't want Oscar award. What we want is, you know, it's a big old Nigerian movie. So that's on the one end. And then people like Molanlisa Chinda, Bisola, and a host of other high class socialites who were never each other's friends. They knew, all they wanted to do was to bitch about each other, envy each other, and outdo each other. Some of them were even sleeping with each other's husbands, all in the name of, you know, they just took it as one thing, normal thing that happened. Like, so when Jide Kosoko died, you know, it was obvious that the Holloway regime was coming to an end. As a matter of fact, had come to an end. The banks were closing in. Akin Holloway had to go beg the governor's mom so that they can help him extend the date for foreclosure of the particular resort. The line, it didn't work out. Even though they told him they were going to give him like 2 years, it didn't work out. You know, everything was just done in a jiffy. They lost everything, you know, in a twinkle of an eye. But the curious thing there is that, you know, as much as a lot of activity going on in the movie was sort of disjointed. Quite all right. What I liked about the movie was that it portrayed that class. You know, when you're looking for a movie that has a lot of class, a lot of, you know, partying and all that, and portraying and exuding that wealth, yes, the Blinks of Lagosians had it. But in terms of having a coordinated storyline, they did not have a coordinated storyline. Everybody in the movie just wanted to show, you know, they acted out their part without effectively working as a team to deliver that perfect storyline. That was the problem with the movie. Apart from that, every member, even Tony Abraham was what would I call it now, this get rich quick, or this newly rich, novel rich people, you know, who was bent on edging into the high class, you know, 1% of 1% of Lagos. In fact, she was in there, no one took her seriously, but they tolerated her because she had a lot of money, too much money. So she was the new person that was on board, did not have as much education as the others had, or class, but they just had to tolerate her there. So everyone acted out their roles the way they were supposed to act it out, without carrying everyone along to give it a good storyline. I can't say I fault anyone's part, anyone's acting, but the movie in its own was disjointed. So that was the problem in the movie. As much as I enjoyed it, the glees and glamour and all that in Blinks of Lagosians, it was a disjointed movie, and I was somewhat disappointed about the outcome of the movie. Right, good a thing though, it ended well, it ended okay, just, you know, okay, but it's just an okay movie because they failed to deliver something appropriate. It would have been better if the storyline was lengthened a bit to get to a desired end, or, you know, something was coordinated in a rather good wave to give a good plot. But all in all, well, I can't complain. What do you expect? But the locations that were used for the movie were excellent. The setting was wonderful. The sound, the light, cinematography was awesome. I can't complain about that. This brings my movie review to an end. I'm gonna be rating the movie a 4/10, right? So if this is your first time here, please do well to hit on the subscribe button, turn up your post notifications so that you'll be alerted when a new movie comes up. Thank you so much for joining me, and I'll see you next time. Bye.